Hey Derry, we're Hogan here, VIP Boxing.
All good mate, I'm good, I'm with Rob. Hopefully our head coach, taking over the amateurs, and you know, today's the launch of the new gym. Basically we've been open all 2 or 3 weeks now, but today we're letting the community see what we're really about, and it involves everyone down. We've got a football tournament on the field outside, what he's done a bit of filming of. I think it's got 20 teams in it. We've got 10 live bands on downstairs, we've got a bouncy castle coming, all food, barbecue, you know, everything, what's all free.
Yeah.
Me and the lads are 50-50 promotions have provided, and you know, hopefully it's the start of something big for myself and the gym and the community and the people of the area.
And do you want to affiliated
with now? We're going to be affiliated with Derry ABC. Obviously, I've got to take a backward step where I'm still got a pro licence, but Rob, Derby, Mo, all the other coaches who are involved, you know, are going to hopefully take up one into a big future. And you know, it's about just giving kids something back, and I've always wanted to do it. It's always been a dream of mine, and you know, to put something back in, and now being given the opportunity, and thanks to Robbie and the other coaches, and you know, it's a good thing for me.
Well, it's right in the centre of the community, isn't it? And it's like middle of the state, isn't it? So you know, it's access to all the local youth around here, isn't it? Yeah.
We're in a prime location, basically. We're in Liverpool L3 city centre. Mm-hmm. It's in an area where, you know, it hasn't got many things in the area. There's no youth club or nothing. Well, he is a youth club, but you know, it's only a small one in this building. And you know, to put something back in and to get something back out of the kids, and you know, I'm happy and I'm delighted that, as I keep saying, going on about Robbie and Derry and the other coaches, Jay McPhee and them who were helping me out, and I'm over the moon by it.
Yeah, well, it's really nice, isn't it? Nice, clean, nice and bright,
bright
than your own place, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit brighter. You know, it didn't look like this maybe 4 weeks, 5 weeks ago when I first took over it. A lot of time being spent in with the people of the area who's helped me out, and my mates who've come in, and you know, we've laid carpets.
Oh, I know, you've still got big ideas, you still want to extend here and there. And
yeah, there's loads what we're going to do to it. I mean, I'm trying to make it into like a full-time education centre. That's my main goal. And
yeah,
you know, I want to give kids from a young age, turn them up to attitude, respect about nutrition, and you know, these kids don't go on to fight or compete. At least they're doing something, they're learning manners, they're learning respect. And
it's about boxing, is it? It's about general life in itself, learning them about it.
Don't get away from gangs, and you know, we want good things for them, and you know, I'm happy.
You know, people know if you work hard in boxing, then you achieve, and that's the same with their life, isn't it?
Hard work, and you get somewhere, don't you?
Yeah.
Don't put the hard work, and you get nowhere in life.
And as Robbie's just said, we've got good numbers now. I think I've got 30 to 40 kids in every night of the week. I think Robbie and myself and the other staff and the coaches sat down last week, and I think about 16 of them are going to be getting carded in the next couple of weeks. And you know, hopefully
when the new season starts,
and then you know, we'll be down around the country on different shows and going around different clubs sparring, and you know, I'm moving on.
Oh, that's great. I mean, I remember that. You know what I mean? The best members of my life when we was all going away. I know it's an individual sport, but when you go as a team together, it's great, isn't it?
Good camaraderie, isn't it? And they get to learn a lot as well, not just don't want to stay in just one gym. You need to move around and learn about boxing and life in general.
Yeah,
how you behave yourself when you go to other gyms.
Another thing, Derry, you're not always just as an opening day, you're trying to raise funds, aren't you?
Yeah, we've got a kid, you know, Josh, in the nursery downstairs. You know, he's just been diagnosed with a brain tumour, and you know, today was about the launch of the gym and whatever, and then you know, me and the lads are 50-50 promotions, Anthony Godfrey and Neil McIntyre. We sat down and we thought that, you know, it's gonna generate a bit of money, but you know, we've done the day for free. And then we're gonna put all the food for free, but today we decided that, you know, they'll be paying £1 for a burger, £1 for a hot dog, and all the money what goes for the car park and that as well. It's all, you know, every bit of money what gets donated is gonna be given to the kids, you know, to, you know what I mean? It's not gonna help them massively, but hopefully he goes on to fight his battle, and you know, send him on a little holiday, or you know, buy himself some nice presents. Yeah, a little help.
Haven't you set up a fundraising page or something?
Yeah, well, that's the aim we're going to go down. You know, we've got the nursery, the people in the nursery, you know, they'll give us the go ahead to help him out, and know, I want to try and raise as much money as I can for them. You know, we're a close-knit community around here, and you know, every little helps.
Well, I suppose I know you don't really go on Twitter much, do you?
No, I'm never on it.
I presume you'll be able to follow this fundraising on your Twitter
account. Yeah, you can follow it, and you can follow what we're going to do, what the goals are going to be, and and you know, you can follow Derry ABC in there as well. That's also on a Twitter page. And if you want to follow me for banter, you can follow me for banter. But sometimes to give me stick because I'll always beat you.
Are you and Curtis have got one of the two biggest tweeters in boxing.
Me and him just laugh at it. You know, me and him just give each other little text messages now and again. And I think me and him should start picking on people instead of getting picked on there. But no, I enjoy it. No, it's good to communicate with the fans as well. You know, at the end of the day, I'm a boxing fan myself. And, you know, people out there spend good, well-earned money coming to watch a fight. So, you know, giving a little text to people now and again, you know, it goes a long way.
Talking about that now, you've got
I'm fighting for the WBA international title on October 25th. Yeah, at the Echo Arena. It's a great arena in my own city.
And it's on the 25th of October?
Yeah, 25th of October. No opponent named yet. There's been a talk of a good few ones who are big names, and you know, I'm looking forward to that.
A lot of people want revenge over you, though.
I think a lot of people. I mean, I want a revenge over a lot of people, but you know, I'm one of them lads who put everything on the line.
Yeah.
I fight every last minute of every fight. I'm always in an entertainment fight, win, lose or draw, and that's what it's about. Good quality for money, and that's why I love the sport.
Right, well, listen, good luck for the 25th. Good luck for this great day. So we're going to hang down and catch a bit. You've got some lads going to be doing a bit of sparring.
Yeah, some kids, some of the gyms coming down to do a bit of sparring from Bootle ABC, and you know, you'll see the kids and that later on the pads, and I'm working well.
Well, listen, good luck with the day.
Thanks. Take care, man. Appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Nice one.
Cheers.